This is the Engwe P26 electric bike. Comes with a lot of features as standard, including disc brakes front and rear, seven gears. It even comes with a kickstand and the bike rack. The lights are directly connected to the battery, and it even has a brake light. The supercomputer can be used to set a lot of parameters and to record your progress, and the whole bike comes in at €1,049 direct from Engwe. One big problem with the bike is that the charging port and the battery release are close together, and if you touch the key on the charging port, you're going to blow a fuse inside the battery or do some other damage. Today we have a quick fix for all that.
Now, so this is how we're going to get out of this situation. As you can see, this lock isn't great, so it's practically all the time open. And as you can see from the sticker, don't put any metal objects in there. The last bike that I had, the lock was on the battery, but with this particular model, it's on the bike, and it's just by pure accident that I hit it. Obviously, this happened earlier today, so I'm just recreating what I done. The symptoms, just to make sure that it is the fuse, is that when you plug in your charger, it stays green. You don't get any reaction that it is charging. And on top of that, you don't get anything when you press this button. So let us begin. But before we begin, you need to get these fuses. They're the mini fuse type. They're rated at 10 amp, and they're the mini red fuse. I got them in Halfords. They're about €3.70 for just two, which is massively overpriced. But if you can get them online, but as you know, when the bike is broken, you just need to act fast. So I just paid it. So we have the two of these, and we can get cracking with the disassembly. Now, the first thing to note is, even though that the charging port is on this side, that we're actually going to be working on the other side, the part that connects onto the bike. So there's six screws here, but we're not going to go near these two. It's not because we for any safety thing, but it's just that we don't need to. So we'll just concentrate on these four screws here. And I'll get them done now straight away. Might need a bigger screwdriver. Now that this is open, there's about 36 volts going through it, so it can still be fairly harmful. There's a fair amount of amps, but just being careful not to touch anything. So this is the black line coming in from the charging port, and this is the red one. So this is more than likely the fuse that we need to concentrate on. So if I just get a pliers and just take the saw. It's not that easy. Yeah, so here we are. And with our fuse tester, we can see that we're not getting anything. It's just not working at all. And what we would get on a normal fuse is that it would go up towards 1.5 and 9 volt. So we know this one is good. And I'll just insert that into the bike. That's covered. And just in case you're wondering, on the other side there's a green 15 amp, but I think it's 50. Yeah, I'm not too sure what it is. this fuse runs from the battery into the bike, but in our case we're just going on the charging port. So even though this isn't put together properly, I just swing it around to the, well, just when you're reassembling this, remember there's a gasket here that needs to be, everything is sort of pushed in, but the gasket sort of keeps the water out. This is going to be on the bottom of the bike, so make sure you assemble it properly. I'm just going to speed through reassembling this part, and we can go back and check it, see if it works. It's all back together now, and it's back charging as normal. I'm ready to go. I wouldn't say it's easy to put the cover back on and make sure you know what you're doing and don't trap any wires on it, but it's definitely a quick fix for maybe a couple of cent or one. 185 if you go to Halfords, 370 for the price of two. But yeah, it should be good to go, and enjoy your bike.